This video is about a chatbot that will actually make you a genius.
So many people have obviously seen how useful it is that right at the moment of recording, the server has crashed.
And you'd think that that would stop me from making the video, but no, I got future David to record. He's just the guy in a different jumper. Anyway, this is ChatGPT. You can ask it questions like, what's your favorite type of ice cream? And it'll give you human dialogue like,
as a language model, I do not have personal preferences or the ability to taste food.
Okay, let me show you something that it's actually useful for.
So let's say, for example, I'm learning this code, but I have absolutely no idea what this code does because I've never programmed using this particular type of code before. So what I can do is I can literally copy and paste it. I'll put it into the ChatGPT and be like, explain to me what this does and how it works. Then amazingly, it tells me exactly what it does. It tells me that it's a Python script that interacts with a certain library to interact with OpenAI's chatbot on their website.
But not all of us are code monkeys, so you might be wondering, are there uses for normal humans?
It doesn't have to be code, it can be any sort of thing that you want to learn. So for example, this is a Wikipedia page about the nephron. Now the nephron is notoriously quite a complicated thing to understand. It's a thing that exists in your kidney, and if you look at this, it's like, it's composed of the renal corpuscle and renal tubule, and there's a bunch of capillaries and blah blah blah. Complicated. So what you can do is you can actually just copy and paste this, for example, and be like, can you explain this to me in a way that a third grader would understand? I'll just pretend that I'm going to be a third grader for now. And this is really complicated. It summarizes to amazingly say, the nephron is a tiny part of the kidney that helps clean the blood. It has a bunch of tiny tubes and filters inside of it that take waste and extra water outside the blood and turn it into urine. So the reason that this new method is so powerful and so exciting is because of the way that it can tailor the answers directly to what exactly you need.
Just to illustrate the power of context, I've asked ChatGPT to respond to this prompt. If I were to remind the other cell organelles that as a mitochondria, I am the powerhouse of the cell, how would I do this in a friendly way? Speak as if I was a pumpkin farmer who was territorial by my place in the cell as well as possessive of my pumpkins. Hey there everyone, I just want to remind you all that as the mitochondria, I'm the powerhouse of this cell. And just like farmer takes care of their pumpkins, I take care of our cell. So let's all work together and make this a great place to be.
Anyway, I was getting a bit too into that. Let's move on and forget that ever happened. But with OpenAI's chatbot, you could just ask it, hey, can you teach me how to make a website with a picture of a dog on it? Show a picture of a cute dog when I enter the website, and it'll be like, here's an example of how to do exactly that. I'm just going to copy and paste this code into somewhere and see if it actually works. Copy and paste that there. If I go to dog.html, well, maybe come up with a picture of a cute dog. Here, a cute dog is in the form of this question mark because when you actually look at the code itself, it's got www.example.com/cutedog.jpg. So you actually have to put in your own image there. So here, I put in the image there and I'm going to save that, refresh that, and now you've got and responsive one, but a website nonetheless that actually shows you a cute dog from what the AI has told me to do. So let's say that you've got a super complicated subject like medical pathophysiology, the study of how diseases happen in the body. Let me show you this. This is actually an old note that I took from medical school back when I used to type huge, humongous notes.
So I've copied and pasted these bullet points about the structure of the nephron, and I want to know how does this actually relate to disease itself?
Which parts of the below process are affected in renal disease? And so here now is actually giving me a really, really good answer of like, you know, in this capillary, in the glomerular capillaries, the filtration of blood might be impaired. And basically it's gone through all these different parts of the kidney that I've laid out and explained why exactly they might be affected by kidney disease.
After all, in medicine,
we never kid about the kidneys. Yeah. Now this is intuitively extremely powerful, but I'm going to teach you a few more ways that you can use AI to make it even more powerful. Before I do that, I want to let you know that I'll be writing up a little stuff about AI and the things that I learn in my newsletter called Davy's Notes. It's a free newsletter where I'm going to teach you all the stuff that I learn as I learn it myself. In this newsletter, I'll share things like productivity tips and reflections, and I want to make it personal, but also very, very helpful for you in your own life. The link to sign up will be in the comments and description below. Now, as promised, here are five different ways to make ChatGPT even more powerful. First of all, you might have a situation where you get a paragraph and the paragraph is detailed enough, but not that detailed. So for example, tell me about the philosophy of happiness. Here you've got a really decent paragraph, but this is just one paragraph, right? Like, what if you wanted to, for example, read a whole essay about the philosophy of happiness? What you can do is you can specify a word count, and that forces the AI to actually output more stuff. So for example, if I was to say, tell me about the philosophy of happiness, write it in the form of a 2000 word essay. And then you can see that now you've prompted it to give you much more depth on a particular subject. So you can use this when you're thinking about academic subjects, but also when you're thinking about things like code, for example. You might ask it to give you more depth on a particular piece of code. Here, it's given a huge amount of information about happiness, which is really cool. The second really useful tip is to actually make it use comparisons. Why? So for example, if I wanted to code a backend framework using Python, how does this differ from doing the same thing in JavaScript? Please give examples. And so here you can see that it started to actually display the code, but also display the code for the different types of languages that you might use. It's so smart that it actually tells you the similarities between them, but also the differences between them, just like anyone would if they were teaching you something. Tip number three is to actually ask things for more specific examples. Let's say that I wanted to apply for a job where I have to serve coffee. Can you give me an example of a cover letter that I should write to the company? Here it does said, I'm writing to apply for customer service position at company name. I have previous experience working in customer service and I have a proven track record of making customers happy. Thank you for considering my application. Sincerely, blah. And then it even explains to you the stuff that you should highlight within that cover letter. It's really cool. The fourth tip is that you should give it some ways and examples if you want it to format in a certain way. Let's say that I wanted it not only to generate a list of ideas for a party, but the things I might need for that party. Let's say Mario Party, and then put this thing here, and then put Mario hat, Donkey Kong outfit, green shell, I don't know, and then two, and then see if that sort of puts it out in the way that you want it to. Okay, this is perfect. And so the reason that this works is you have to realize that ChatGPT is a chatbot AI, but fundamentally what it actually is, it's an AI that figures out how best to complete sentences. And so if you give it a pattern of how to complete those sentences, then that really helps it along, helping it figure out what you want it to do exactly. So if you keep that principle in mind, you're gonna get a lot more out of it and a lot more in the data that you want. Here, it's perfectly done the thing that I wanted it to. It's put in casino night and then items and then different things that you might need. This has actually worked out super duper well. Here, I'm gonna have a masquerade and the items are gonna be masks, feathers, glitter, face paint, and a prize for the best mask. The fifth tip is that you can actually hook it up to WhatsApp or other places, or in my particular case, if I don't want to do the technical version of that, I'll actually just add it to my home screen on the phone so that I have easy access to any time. On my iPhone, the way to do it is you go to Safari, then you go to the ChatGPT, and then you click the button at the bottom, the middle button, and then you just click add to home screen, and then it comes up as an icon so you can access it anytime. This new, really powerful personal assistant that's better than Siri, better than Google Assistant. This technology is truly amazing. I think that the implications for the world are actually very, very significant. Not a lot of people outside of technology have talked about it yet. I'm sure you're gonna find out very soon that people will talk about it. For me, for example, for being a doctor, I can see how this would be extremely useful for being able to summarize patient files. I can even perhaps use the generative part of it to sort of summarize things and give patients information, for example. I reckon if you look at this video 10 or 20 years in the future, a lot of people will take for granted how like ridiculously incredible this actually is right now. And I'm excited to be one of the first people on YouTube, hopefully, to talk about it. But for the next video, I decided to make an AI dog. So subscribe if that video is not out yet. Otherwise, the video will be right here. Woof woof.